When the war began in September 1939, I was just 12 years old. My mother told me how dangerous it would be if I stayed in London. I knew she was right, but after my father left for war, I couldn't bear the thought of leaving her on her own. My sister and I were evacuated on the 13th of February 1940, along with more than a million others. We were sent to a small market town in Sussex. We had a long day and were very tired. We did not know where we were going or what we to expect. We fell asleep until we were jolted awake as we arrived at the train station.
Ethel, I've been terribly delayed at the in town and I can't get to the train station. The children would be waiting there for us. Can you make it down there? See who can get there first. I'll see you there. Bye.
So late. Should we go back and get some tea? Come on, girls. and open spaces, I shouldn't think.
No.
Dear Diary, it is the end of our first day in the countryside. We waited for ages at the station for Ethel and Gertie to pick us up. They seemed very nice, but a bit batty. Tomorrow we are going to the farm to meet their dear friend, Farmer Fred.
Ladies, you must be Maddie and Jessica. How do you do? I'm Farmer Fred. Right, that's what you can call me, okay? Are you looking at my pigs?
Yeah. Well, we haven't seen much pigs in London.
No, I don't expect you have. They're big, aren't they?
Much bigger than our dinner.
Have you seen the cows? Come with me. This is a cow, this one. Look, see, and the ones, because he's got the teats, yes?
What's about?
So they're a teats where the milk comes from. That's where we get the milk from. Yeah?
And why have they got horns?
Well, they're the bullocks. They're the ones that get fattened up for the meat. And they get so big and then we send them to the market.
Why do you have to kill
pigs? Well, so you can eat the meat. Keep everybody alive and eating. That's called hay. And that's when we cut the grass. In the summer, and it all dries out, and they eat it in the winter. Because in the summer, all the cows would be in the field. We keep the cows and the bullocks in the barn in the winter. And then all their poo and the straw we put down for their bed. Then that goes on the field to fertilise the fields, grow the crops. But you'll learn all that because you're going to be here a long time, I think. So, I think you'll enjoy yourself when you get used to the animals. And here are all the fruit trees, you see. The apples and pears.
Do animals eat
fruit? No, we sell that at the market for the people. We've got the names of the apples on the end of the road, you see, so we know which ones are which. The sheep, keep there in pens at the moment.
They stink.
No, that's just animal smell. You'll get used to that. You're going to be in the country for a while. Have to be a bit careful with the bigger animals, so I'll keep out of their way. And these won't hurt you. Good old. They won't hurt you. Right, young ladies, I've got to go back and do some more work out in the field, so you can leave you to explore. And you know where the house is, and when you get tired and you want something to eat, you go and see them.
Thank you.
Dear Mother, we are enjoying staying here but are missing you terribly. The old ladies that are looking after us have been very kind. We have seen lots of farm animals and can't wait for you to come and visit us to see them for yourselves. We have seen some more children arriving from the east end of London and are making lots of new friends. Some of the new arrivals have not been as lucky as us and have been split up from their brothers and sisters. Have you heard any news from Father? Is he safe? We pray for him every night and can't wait until the day he comes when we are all together again.